接下来一位分享的嘉宾，也是我们在社区里可能在X或者是在海外平台上经常看到的工作流和插件的作者 ImpactFrames。然后他今天想跟大家分享基于这个万象的新的模型，他所做的一些 workflow 和训练的尝试。Welcome。
Hello, welcome. I'm ImpactFrames. I'm a content creator and custom node developer. I started using Comfy UI with when Comfy basically posted that Reddit post the first time. After 2 months, I started using Comfy UI after 2 months of that post coming from Automatic 1111. So I had an extension before for Automatic 1111 that allowed you to make prompts. And I ported that into Comfy UI. And now this is called If AI Tools. And probably, sorry. How to put this in like full screen? Now it's coming in full screen. Sorry. It's now. Why it doesn't come in? Sorry, it needs to be in full screen, but it's putting like twice. I don't know. Should be the play button. Okay, so I started making custom nodes for Comfy UI with that If AI Tools, and it became a bit like with a lot of dependencies because it was my first node in Comfy UI, and it got out of hand a bit. But it works. You can do like rag tools and chat with PDF and. It has a lot more tools, and then I started making like more things, like the if Trellis node, and yeah. So today I'm gonna talk about how to make a workflow for one using if video prompt, which is a node that helps you to come up with the text prompt. When you are doing like text to video, you need to have like a special kind of prompt that has, you know, it has like components to it, like subject, action, the background, the style, and also some cinematographic element into it that makes the prompt good for video. And this allows you to bypass that tedious process of making the prompt each time, so it can reverse engineer the video. And for that, this thing uses QueenVL 2.5, which is a very powerful model to analyze video and images. And what it does is basically it takes everything into separate frames and finds out kind of the action that is happening into the prompt. It sees the action in the video and kind of the cinematic elements and makes the prompt that is kind of good for the text-to-video mode. And then you can change this into another node. I made if Gemini, which basically can generate images, and because it has a better reasoning, it's a more powerful mode. You can manipulate the result from the first node. You can actually make everything in if Gemini, but the idea of using if video prompt is that it's open source and you can run it in your computer very easily, because it's basically like a very, very small model. So you can run it like in a 4 gig graphic card, and it has some feature to unload the model when you finish with it. And when you pass it to the next one, basically here we are passing it to the next one and we are changing the subject of the prompt. And the result is kind of the, basically it passed again into the one model. The one model has, there is a one connection at the top where you can basically concatenate like the token for the LoRa. And after you get the LoRa and the prompt and everything together, you can make like the video with the different character. So, and now I'm experimenting with a step phone and a character that I made a long time ago that I have very little animations of it. And now I can have my character animated with the same technique, but using a step phone, which has like a better control. You can do proper control nets, and this workflow has one segment with the native custom nodes for ComfyUI, and it has another one with the one wrapper by KJ. So when you download the if video prompt, this is gonna be in the workflow folder, so it's all together there. And now I probably wanna show you kind of the results. So this is one with my character kind of, this needs to be into. So this is basically taken from an anime video and it's passing exactly my character that I showed you before, because I made a LoRa. I made a LoRa with it, but also I put like the initial image. Here is the result of the first workflow without a step phone. So this is like the base 1.3 billion parameter model from one. and no LoRa, just the flat color LoRa. And this is kind of another test, which is also having to play with, how is the name? Having to play with the browser because it's a WebP. And this is like with my character, it's not perfect because the LoRa that I trained for this was for the base model, and it kind of came up a bit ugly, but now there is a Musubi trainer that has the ability to train the step phone model, and I expect that it's gonna be like a better quality than now. So yeah, that's all that I have for now. And thank you for the invitation to Shanghai from the Comfy org and the people that is from the venue. And thank you to you for listening to me. Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Thank you as well for flying over. 大家可以在那个X 或者是 GitHub 上面找到 ImpactFrames 的账号，然后他平时有分享和开源很多关于这个 LoRa 还有视频训练最近做了比较多的一些工作，包括插件和工作流，然后。